Well, good morning, everybody. The Lord be with you and also with you. As we begin our worship, we remember. God the Father, who helps us to love worship. God the Son, who helps us to love ourselves. God, the Holy Spirit, who helps us to love each other. So welcome once again to our socially distanced collective worship. This morning I'm continuing to think about some of the values that we need to have with each other. We've thought about resilience and respect, and Richard earlier this week focused on change. Well, change can lead us to something else. Fear. So this morning, I'm going to be thinking about how fear can make us feel and how we can overcome it. But before we do, we're going to sing our song. Now, I've got a new one that I thought I'd teach you this morning. It's called Nothing Is Too Big, Big, Big. And it's a song that reminds us that no matter how we're feeling or what we feel we're up against, nothing is too big, big, big for our God to sort out. So if you're in the classroom, you might want to stand up near your desk, give yourself a bit of space. Remember your social distancing. And if you're at home, then find a little bit of space and you can join in wherever you're watching this morning. So how do the actions go to this song? So it starts off, we shuffle that way and we go diddly diddly dee, hey, diddly diddly dee, hey. And then you can turn in a little circle, whichever way you want to do it, move around a little bit, and then we do it again, diddly diddly dee, hey, diddly diddly dee, hey, and then we move around. And then it goes, nothing is too big, big, big for his power, power, nothing is too little, little, little for his care. And then we go, nothing is too big, big, big for his power, nothing is too little, little, little for his care. Nothing, and then we've got this, like putting your arms around something really big, so nothing is too big, big, big for his power, and nothing is too incy-wincy for his care. And then nothing is too big, 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 so we're pushing something away for his power, and nothing is too iddly-widdly for his care. Care. Okay, so that's the chorus, so we'll have a little go at that. And then it goes, he is God of the big, God of the little, got to crash down a little ball, God of the stuff, somewhere in the middle, we pat our tummy, the king of moving mountains, so you make a little mountain, moving mountains, loves you more than you will ever know. Okay. So we're going to give it a go. I know it's a new one, so we'll see how we get on. Okay, let's give it a go.
For his care.
Here comes the bus.
Big, big, big.
For his power.
I wonder how you felt when the music was playing and various images were playing on the screen. The church was dark and gloomy. There was just the one candle lit, and then suddenly there was a flicker of something going across the screen, and then there was somebody moving around in the background. What was the atmosphere like? How did the mood of it feel? I wonder if it felt a little bit real. Maybe not. Have a little chat with someone next to you about the things that you saw and the things that you felt. Now, the atmosphere was a little bit dark and the mood was probably a little bit scary for some of you. But I wonder if for some of you, I'm sure not the very brave year sixers, but maybe for some of the little ones, it felt a little bit uncomfortable and actually a little bit worrying. Now, actually, all it really was a piece of music from an opera called Romeo and Juliet. Now, that's actually, it's a bit of a tragic love story. It's written by William Shakespeare. Me in the verger's robe, being a bit silly at the front of church. Now, I'm in exactly the same place. I've put the lights on. I'm in my normal clothes. And there's nothing to be worried about at all. So, in fact, those things that were concerning us were all in our imagination. I wonder if you've ever found that with other things that are a little bit more important. Sometimes we have a little bit of a worry, don't we? Maybe going to the dentist, first day in a new class. You've got an exam coming up for dancing or maybe music, or you're playing an important team game. Maybe you're a little bit nervous as well as excited. And then you start to think about all the things that might happen. What happens if I don't play as well as I should do? Or you worry in your new class, what happens if I don't make new friends? Or if you're in a music exam and you hit the wrong note on the piano. And we think about how bad all of that would be, and our imagination starts to get away from us, and we start to build up this picture of something that's far more frightening than it really is. But then we do that thing, whatever it is that we've been building ourselves up to. We confront the challenge. And actually, it's not anything like we imagined it would be, and it all goes really well. Often, being frightened of something is much more frightening than the thing itself. So I wonder what we can do when we're feeling just a little bit scared and fearful. Well, let's first of all have a little bit of a think about some of the things that worry us. So just very quickly, again, in your twos, have a little chat about some of the things that might worry you. Now, I don't know what you've been saying, but I was having a think about maybe some of the things that worried me when I was your age and maybe what worries some of you now. So things like we won't make any new friends in our new class, particularly maybe our year sixes as they go up to the bigger school. And we know that that's going to be a new school with lots of new children. Just the thought of that maybe makes us a little bit anxious. wherever we are, being left out is never a nice thing and worries us. Being left out of the games on the playground, being left out of the friendship group. Maybe moving house can be a little bit worrying because you don't know the new place that you're going to and what it's going to be like and whether your bedroom's going to be wonderful like yours is at the moment. Maybe sometimes we worry a little bit about not being accepted for who I am. See, I'm a little bit silly and a little bit loud, and maybe people won't like that. And then as you move into your new classes, what if our new teacher doesn't like us? Now, when we think about all of those things, we start to see a bit of a pattern. See, most of those problems come down to two things: friendship and change. Now, there will be other things that worry us, but I think for me, and probably for you, those two things are the most worrying about whether we're liked and our friendships and when things change from what we know. I bet if you were going to talk with your classmates and your teachers, maybe you could do it after the assembly and you'd share some of those worries, and I bet they'd fall into, or a lot of them, into those two categories. And actually, that's why school has the golden rules. And we're very keen that everybody follows the values of St. Anne's School. Respecting each other, taking care of each other, being a good friend, listening, being supportive. See, when we feel a bit scared, then we need to talk to others about it, and we need to know that they're going to listen to us and respect us for what we say. We can tell a grown-up how we're feeling and ask them to help us with our fears. Because here's the thing, when we stand up to our fears, normally they're not quite as bad as we thought they were going to be. Now, they won't be as silly as a vicar running around a church in a cape. It'll be something that feels quite real. But when you face them, then the light comes on and it doesn't look so bad. And Jesus said two things that would help us when we're feeling a bit scared. Jesus said, "I am the light of the world." And what Jesus meant was that his light in our lives can drive out the dark. And so the church looks very different with the lights on than it did with just a candle on its own. And Jesus said, "Cast your worries on me." And what Jesus was saying, that we can talk to somebody else, or we can pray to God to help us and to carry those things that worry us. See, Jesus knew that our imaginations are often bigger than our worries. And what we need to do is take those worries to the light of Jesus. And when they do, we'll see that they disappear. So just in a moment's quiet, I'm going to ask some wondering questions. Let's just be quiet for a moment. I wonder if you are scared or worried about something at the moment. I wonder if you've been thinking about that worry and made it bigger than it is. I wonder who you could go and talk to about that worry to make it a little bit smaller. I wonder if you've prayed about it and brought it to Jesus. Remember, a worry hates to be talked about, because when it does, it gets smaller and smaller and eventually disappears. So I'm going to pray now, and then we can join in together with the words of the Lord's Prayer. God of the light, thank you that light banishes darkness, and that joy, hope, and trust will banish fear. Thank you that we don't need to worry about anything. Yes, we should think. Yes, we should be concerned. But worry is a waste of time and a waste of energy. Lord, help us to let you carry those worries for us. And here's a prayer you might like to say in your head. Dear Lord, here's what I'm worried about today. And then you can say that thing in your head that you're worried about. Dear Lord Jesus, I think I'll leave it with you. Thank you. Amen. And so we say together the words on the screen, the words of the Lord's Prayer. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. Thank you once again for joining me today. I'm going to be back next week, and Rachel is also going to be sending a collective worship out next week as well. But for now, go in peace to love and serve the Lord. In the name of Christ, amen.